In this video, you will learn how to create the block unique command. All of this will give you the ability to simplify tasks and simply be more productive. So let me explain you why do we need this tool. I have this block right now, which is the same as this one. So let's see what happens if I modify it. Can you see what happened? I only wanted to change this door, not this one. Since they are the same block, they changed. So I'm gonna undo. So that's why we need our block unique command. If I click on it, it's done. Now let's see what happens if I change again this block. Boom! Can you see that? So that's why we need this handy command. So let's do it! The first step is to type CUI, enter. Let's try it again, CUI, enter. Okay, now we're good. We're gonna create a new command. Let's rename it block unique. And we're gonna type the following code or macro. We're gonna apply. Back again. So now if we look for our block unique command, it's right here. The second step is to add it to our ribbon. I'm gonna add it to my drawing panel for now, but you can add it anywhere you want. Apply and close. So it's right here. You cannot see any icon because I didn't apply any icon to it. But let's use the command again. I'm gonna copy this door. I'm gonna use my brand new block unique command. Click. I'm done. Gonna edit. Just to show you that it works. And boom, it works. So now, you might be thinking, well, I already saw the code. I got it, right? I can leave now. And actually, yeah, you could seriously leave right now. But for you, still there, let me explain you what we really did so you can tweak it and apply it maybe for a different task. So we're gonna go back to the CUI. And we're gonna find our block unique command. So, what we really did was use the flatting command. What is the flatting command? Well, let me show you here. Autodesk Knowledge. Flatting command creates a 2D representation of selected objects and projects them onto the current viewing plane. So you can use flatten to create a 2D drawing from a 3D model, or you can use it to force the thickness and elevation of selected objects. So basically, this simple command, it's a powerful command that we're not actually using it. And as you can see here, this is even a Lisp. So flatten is a Lisp routine. So if we gave flatten a nice use, it's to make this block unique command, because it will flat the block and it will automatically rename it. So it will give it a new name, which means it's a new block. So basically we're using flatten right here. These two C's means the escape. So we can get out of any command. Then we're using flatten. We're using this semicolon, which means enter. A dash for pause or for user input, because we're gonna click to select the block. Then we're hitting again enter. And then we're saying no. And enter again, and enter to accept. And then finally this dash or underscore, sorry, means we're entering a new command, which is RE, which means regenerate, or regenerate the whole drawing and kind of refresh our new block, and enter. So that's basically what we did. So now you know exactly how we create this make block unique command. For more tricks, subscribe, comment, and share, because we are lazy, lazy, lazy.